As we are currently in the midst of the global coronavirus disease 2019 pandemic, it is imperative for us to be updated on the disease process. I am here to share some literature on the pathology of COVID-19 based on few autopsy studies that are recently published. We are aware that most of the patients with COVID-19 are asymptomatic or experienced only mild symptoms like fever, dry cough and shortness of breath. However, some individuals deteriorated rapidly and developed acute respiratory distress syndrome. Acute lung injury and ARDS are two entities that have precise definitions from a clinical standpoint. However, from a pathologic standpoint, most of these cases present with any of the four histological patterns, which are diffuse alveolar damage, acute eosinophilic pneumonia, acute fibrinous and organizing pneumonia, diffuse alveolar hemorrhage with capillaritis. Diffuse alveolar damage is the most common pattern encountered. The histologic findings in ARDS will depend on when a biopsy is obtained during the course of the disease. Histologically, diffuse alveolar damage is typically divided into an acute exudative phase and an organizing or proliferative phase. The acute phase generally occurs during the first week following the pulmonary insult, with the organizing phase occurring after the first week. Acute phase is usually easily recognizable. The findings are generally diffuse or patchy. By day 2, intraalveolar edema and interstitial widening are apparent. Hyaline membranes may be seen at this point that reaches a peak by 4 to 5 days after the initial insult. Generally, inflammation is relatively sparse. Thrombi may be present and may be quite extensive. The formation of thrombi in diffuse alveolar damage is due to local alterations in the coagulation pathway and should not be considered evidence of an underlying thromboembolic disorder in this patient. Organizing phase is characterized by relatively uniform interstitial fibrosis associated with pronounced type 2 pneumocyte hyperplasia. The hyaline membranes gradually disappear and become incorporated into the alveolar septa. However, residual hyaline membranes may be identifiable depending on the timing of biopsy and the course of the disease. Other features that may be seen are cytologic atypia in the type 2 pneumocytes, squamous metaplasia, as well as organizing fibroblastic tissue seen in the air spaces, particularly the alveolar ducts. The process actually represents a continuum and overlapping features may be encountered. With this understanding of the pulmonary pathology of ARDS, we shall review the data on the histologic findings in COVID. This is the first paper that enumerates the findings of two complete autopsies in COVID-positive individuals who died in United States in March 2020. The first case is that of a 77-year-old man who died after having fever and chills for 6 days. His nasopharyngeal swab was tested positive for SARS-CoV-2. The main findings related to COVID in this case was limited to the respiratory system. The bilateral lungs were heavy, red to maroon in color, edematous with a diffusely firm consistency. There were right pleural adhesions. The airways were patent with no evidence of mucus plugging. These are photomicrographs of the airways. The bronchioles are outlined for better visualization. The lumens of the airways are patent and empty. There is no evidence of mucus plugging seen. The bronchial walls appear pale stained due to edema. The alveoli are shown here. The alveoli are outlined blue. Within each alveoli is a pink membrane that is marked with an arrow. This membrane is formed of fibrin, cellular debris and few inflammatory cells. These are the hyaline membranes, which are the telltale evidence of diffuse alveolar damage acute phase. The alveolar septal capillary showed marked condition, which is highlighted with yellow arrows. The bronchioles are thickened in this case with marked mucosal edema and presence of mild chronic inflammation, which is predominated by lymphocytes that are highlighted with an arrow. Similarly, there was patchy inflammation within the interstitium, which was predominated by lymphocytes. The prominent alveolar condition is also evident in this photomicrograph that is shown with the yellow arrow again. As is common in diffuse alveolar damage, thrombi were noted within few small pulmonary artery branches. Immunohistochemistry was done to characterize the inflammatory infiltrate. The results showed a sparse infiltrate of CD3 positive T lymphocytes that are highlighted with a brown color. Similarly, there were presence of CD4 and CD8 lymphocytes with a mild predominance of CD8 positive T cells. CD20 positive B cells were sparse in this case. Next is a case of a 42-year-old man with a history of myotonic muscular dystrophy who presented to a community hospital in a critical condition. His symptoms upon admission were that of fever, shortness of breath and cough. He survived for only a few hours in the hospital. Autopsy findings showed that the lungs were heavy, red to tan, mottled in appearance, and both lower lobes had a diffusely saturated dark red appearance. The airways were patent in this case. Microscopic examination of the lungs showed marked inflammation. The parenchyma revealed filling of the peribronchial spaces, which are marked with yellow. The spaces were filled with neutrophils and histiocytes. There was no evidence of hyaline membrane formation in this case. Aspirated foreign material was noted within few airways. Thus, the features in this case are those of acute bronchopneumonia with focal aspiration. To summarize the findings in the two cases in this report, the lungs in both the cases were red, heavy and edematous. Microscopic findings of the 77-year-old man showed diffuse alveolar damage, whereas the other case showed acute bronchopneumonia with focal aspiration. The next is a case series that is in its preprint that enumerates the relevant cardiopulmonary findings of a series of four cases from United States with SARS-CoV infection. The four descendants included males and female patients ranging from ages 44 to 76 years. In all cases, the clinical course consisted of approximately 3 days of mild cough and fever with sudden respiratory decompensation. Chest X-rays revealed bilateral ground glass opacities consistent with ARDS. All the patients were tested positive for COVID. Gross examination of the lungs appeared heavy, red to maroon in color, edematous, hemorrhagic. There was mild pleural effusion in these cases. The bronchi revealed thick white mucus plugs in the lungs of one patient and pink froth in the airways of the other three. Mild to moderate serosanguinous pericardial and pleural effusions were also present. In some cases, small firm thrombi were seen in sections of the peripheral parenchyma of the lung. Histologic examination of the lungs showed bilateral diffuse alveolar damage with mild to moderate lymphocytic infiltrate and extensive hemorrhage. There was presence of fibrin thrombi. There was also notable presence of megakaryocytes, which were positive for CD61, which is the marker for megakaryocytes that is stained brown in color. These represent the resident megakaryocytes in the pulmonary capillaries. There was also marked nuclear hyperchromasia and atypia in these cells. Desquamated type 2 pneumocytes with mild cytomegaly and enlarged nuclei Bright eosinophilic nucleoli were also present within the alveolar space, which is highlighted here. This is a fluorescent stain, again highlighting the viral inclusion particles. The most significant gross examination findings of the heart were presence of cardiomegaly and right ventricular dilatation. The cut surface of the myocardium was firm, red-brown in color, and free of significant lesions. The coronary arteries showed no significant stenosis or acute thrombus formation. The sections from the myocardium showed scattered individual cell myocyte necrosis, which is marked with a blue arrow. There was no obvious viral cytopathic changes that is evident by light microscopy in this case. The dominant process in all the cases was consistent with that of a diffuse alveolar damage, with pneumocyte showing viral cytopathic changes. Next paper is that of two patients from Wuhan who underwent lung lobectomies for adenocarcinoma and were retrospectively found to be positive for COVID. The first one is a case of an 84-year-old female with a tumor in the middle lobe of the right lung. Histopathology of the lung parenchyma adjacent to the neoplasm is described. There was evident alveolar damage with alveolar edema, with marked alveolar edema, and proteinaceous exudates were seen. There was prominent inspissated spherical secretions or globules noted, which is highlighted with the arrow marks. There was vascular congestion, but patchy and mild inflammatory infiltration. The alveoli are outlined with yellow. Focal fibrin clusters mixed with mononuclear inflammatory cells and multinucleated giant cells were noted within the alveoli. There was patchy and severe pneumocyte hyperplasia and interstitial thickening, indicating an ongoing reparative process in this case. Suspected viral inclusions were also noted in some of these cells, which are circled as shown in the picture. The next is a case of a 73-year-old male with a tumor in the lower lobe of the right lung. The histopathology in the lung parenchyma adjacent to the neoplasm is described. The surrounding lung parenchyma was patchy, showed patchy evidence of proteinaceous and fibrin exudates. There was diffuse thickening of the alveolar walls consisting of proliferating interstitial fibroblast and type 2 pneumocyte hyperplasia. Focal fibroblast plugging, which is highlighted by an arrow mark, is seen in the picture above. There was presence of multinucleated giant cells, again noted, that is again shown by the smaller arrow, within the air spaces. These indicate varying degrees of proliferative phase of diffuse alveolar damage. Some areas of abundant alveolar macrophages along with type 2 pneumocyte hyperplasia was noted. To summarize, the histopathological findings that were prominent in COVID patients was that the airways in most of these cases were patent, the bronchi were thickened, edematous with mild chronic inflammation, the lungs were heavy, maroon red and edematous in its appearance, diffuse alveolar damage was the main underlying pathology, acute bronchopneumonia was seen in one case. Viral cytopathic changes were seen within the pneumocyte in most of these cases. Thank you.